Well, hello and welcome to another movie review by Movie Burner Entertainment. My name is Stephen and today I am going to be talking about 2018's The Commuter. This is directed by Jean Colette Serra and written by Byron Willinger and story by Philip de Blasi. And this stars Liam Neeson, Vera, Farmiga and Patrick Wilson. The Commuter really took me by surprise in how long it would keep me interested. The trailer already showed us that Liam Neeson's character, Michael McCauley, an ex-cop now working and selling insurance, is met by a stranger, Joanna, played by Vera Farmiga, who offers him a proposition to carry out one task and he could walk away with $100,000 if he succeeds. If he fails, his family will die. Yeah, sometimes trailers can annoy me in the sense where they are really showing you everything. In this case, though, to sell the movie, it was essential to show the good bits. If not handled well, can become stale and uninteresting. Speed managed to do this correctly, set it on a bus, but unfortunately its sequel was a massive flop. Hey, Keanu Reeves didn't even want to be any part of that one. Under Siege is another example of predominantly being set on a ship, which worked even though I'm not a big Steven Seagal fan. Its sequel, just like The Commuter, is set on a train, but this was terribly made and relied on a cardboard cutout villain and what looked like blue screen central everywhere. The Commuter manages to keep you enthralled, and in the first 15 minutes the groundwork is set, and one of the reasons for that is that Liam Neeson's character Michael McCauley isn't the man he used to be. Now 60 years old, he's selling insurance, two mortgages and is about to send his son to college. Unfortunately for Michael, he's been given a severance package and basically he thinks his day can't get any worse. It's worth mentioning that we can get to see a bit of Michael's day-to-day interactions and patterns that he does on a daily basis for the last 10 years. We get to see a bit of interaction with Michael and the other commuters, which serves the storyline later on. Dejected and desperate, Michael, whilst reading a book on the way home to face the music, is approached by a lady named Joanna. There's a little back and forth small talk between both characters until the ex-cop comes out and Michael and asks bluntly, what is it she wants? Joanna offers Michael a tempting offer to find a commuter on the train or face the consequences. This is how the next 90 minutes plays out in the train, with Michael against the clock to figure out who the target is and why this organisation wants this person and what they are carrying. Now, I don't really want to delve into the reasons for their actions, nor do I want to reveal any twists, as I'm basing this review as a non-spoiler to an extent, as I enjoyed a few of the reveals. Mostly what I've said already was in the trailer anyway, so there's nothing spoiled here. The Commuter is a clever written film, and the events in the movie will keep you entertained as the story is one big puzzle solver. Liam Neeson again doesn't let us down. His character has the tendencies of an honest and moral ex-policeman who left all that behind and became an insurance salesman. You can sense a regret in the character on some of his lifestyle choices and career choices, and comes across as a man who would do anything for his family. I'm glad they gave the character a little backstory in his previous work. As the film plays out, you understand why he can think the way he does and how he handles intense situations. Neeson, despite being a serious actor in his younger days, made the transition to action star way back in his Taken days. Heck, he can even go further to his Jedi days in The Phantom Menace in 1999. Unlike the Brian Mills character from the former, McCauley is flawed. He doesn't have the confidence within himself to be able to conquer his insecurities or be decisive as perhaps he once was. Vera Farmiga is terrific in her limited screen time. As the supposed villain of the movie, I think I can say that it's more than the people she works for that are the bigger villains, but nevertheless delves into a cold and calculating way. Joanna, from the kickoff, doesn't beat around the bush with her intentions. Yes, there's a little small talk in there that McCauley cuts down very quickly, but I sense that she was about to explain what she was doing on the train anyway. Farmiga, for the most of the movie, is then on the phone, and although it makes sense for her to be dictating the situation, you couldn't very well have her presence there, and you will realise why in the movie's climactic finale. Patrick Wilson is cop Alex Murphy, not the Robocop one, and is Michael's ex-partner. Murphy comes across as a younger version of McCauley. He appears to have the same work ethos and moral values of Michael, and comes across as a guy who has learned a lot from him. Wilson is one of my favourite actors of the past 10 years, and I have to admit that I was a little disappointed with his screen time. That's not to say that his presence at any point isn't impactful. He appears at the film's first 15 minutes, and we don't get to see him again until the last 20 minutes or so. Overall, The Commuter is a thrilling rollercoaster of a ride, and I'm always happy to see Liam Neeson in a successful and entertaining movie. The pacing and direction by Jean Colette Serra is great, and at no point does the movie slow down. Within the first 15 minutes, you understand the main characters, and you get to understand why McCauley ends up doing what he does. The look of the film and the camera movements within a close proximity on the train works for me, especially during the fight scenes, which were brilliantly and realistically executed. Jonathan Banks, Sam Neill and Elizabeth McGovern all play smaller roles than they would normally play, but add to the weight of the characters. If you haven't yet watched The Commuter, I highly recommend you do.
Remember guys, if you're enjoying the content we're putting out, then do subscribe to us on YouTube at Movie Burner Entertainment and on iTunes and Google Play at The Movie Burner Podcast, whilst also giving us a little follow on Facebook and Twitter at Movie Burners. You can also catch up with all the latest reviews we're putting out on the Movie Burner blog at movieburnerentertainment.org. Until next time, goodbye.